So today's video is all about summer DIY / life hacks. So pretty much like life hacks that you can DIY. Honestly, I'm just like very indecisive, so I couldn't decide which to call it. Summer DIYs or summer life hacks. So we're just gonna kind of combine it, yeah? Also, this is my first summer video of the year, so that's also really exciting. And if you're not already, make sure you are subscribed to my channel down below. I post my videos every single Saturday. So if you are subscribed, you won't miss out on any of my new videos. So yeah, I'm gonna stop rambling, and without further ado, let's get on to summer DIY life hacks. So the first DIY is some ice cream toggles, which are so fun to make and honestly are like really good. So start off with some ice cream cone waffle bowls and then take a paper towel and wet it under the sink and then wring it out so it's just kind of like damp. And then take your paper towel and wrap it around your waffle bowl like this and place it in the microwave for 1 minute. So once it's done, immediately unwrap paper towel from the bowl and then shape it into a taco. For the first 30 seconds when you take it out of the microwave, it's super like malleable and very easy to form, but it hardens back within about 45 seconds, so make sure you do this very fast. Next, just take your choice of ice cream and begin putting it inside of the taco shell. I personally think that the best way to do this is just to take some small spoonfuls of ice cream and then use your fingers to pack it in and smooth it out. It's a bit messy, but I honestly think it's the best way to get looking really good in the end. Once you have filled all of your taco shells, just put them back in the freezer for about an hour so the ice cream kind of like re-solidify. So last but not least, melt some chocolate in the microwave and then use that and kind of drizzle it on top of the taco shells to cover any exposed ice cream and a bit of the taco shell. This is seriously so much fun. You can have a blast doing this with your friends. So while the chocolate is still wet, make sure to put your toppings on. I chose sprinkles, but honestly anything would work as long as it tastes good on ice cream. So anyway, once the chocolate has hardened, that's it for your DIY ice cream tacos. I don't know if you guys ever tried these, but they're basically like copycat choco tacos, which were pretty much like my whole childhood. Except these are way better because you're making them yourself, and like I said, they're really fun to make. Plus, they taste awesome. This next one is probably my favorite, and it's how to make your own DIY giant bubbles. So start off by adding 6 cups of water to a large bowl and then mix in 1/2 cup of cornstarch. This will make your bubbles more durable and make the solution a bit thicker. Before you add any other ingredients, make sure you mix this cornstarch into the water so it's completely dissolved and the water is kind of like a milky white color. Next, just add in 1/2 cup of Dawn dish detergent. I tried a few different variations of this recipe and I found that the brand names of dish detergents work better. Next, you're going to need 1 tablespoon of pure glycerin. You can get this at Walmart or Rite Aid or other kind of like drugstore type things. This is definitely essential for your bubbles, you really can't skip it. Next, just add 1 tablespoon of baking powder. Mix all those ingredients together and you have your own DIY giant bubble solution. Also, the longer you let your bubble solution sit before using it, the better the bubbles will be, so I'd recommend letting it sit for at least 3 hours, preferably overnight. So next, make the actual bubble wand. Just take 2 straws and cut off the bendy part if they're bendy straws. Then take some cotton string and start stringing it through each of the straws. Once you've done that, tie the ends of the string together and then cut off the extra string and you have your own DIY giant bubble wand to go with your bubble solution. And this is what the finished bubble wand should look like. So these are what the bubbles look like. They are so big and really cool. You can make some awesome pictures with these or even just have some fun with your friends outside on a hot summer day. It's a bit messy, so I'd recommend wearing some kind of play clothes that you don't mind getting tons of soap and cornstarch on. But besides that, these are a super fun activity to do in the summer. Also keep in mind that the more you play with the bubbles, the more durable they will be. So the first couple of bubbles might pop at first, but then the rest of them will be really big like this. So this next one is kind of like a DIY instant drink cooler. So start off by adding some water to a big bowl and then add about 1 cup of ice to the water as well. No exact measurements really needed here. And then add about a small handful of salt and then mix that into the water. Due to the chemical reaction between the salt and the ice water, the ice will actually melt, but it will make the water a lot colder. Next, just place your soda can into the ice water solution. And because the ice water solution is much colder than room temperature, the heat energy in the can will be drawn out and then the temperature of the drink inside will rapidly reduce, therefore making it a lot colder. So after about 2 minutes of the can being in the water, your drink should be really cold. This next life hack slash DIY is this really awesome sun tattoo. So pretty much for this, all you need are some very durable waterproof band-aids, and then take some scissors and cut out whatever shape you want your sun tattoo to be. So I chose a heart because that was pretty easy. And also make sure you're cutting this out on the sticky part of the band-aid and not the padded part. So anyway, once you're ready to go out and tan, just take off the backing of the band-aid and stick it on every part of your body you want to, and then just sit out in the sun and enjoy your day. So basically how this works is that if you get a tan, the skin under the band-aid will not get tan at all, so when you take it off, you'll have a cute little sun tattoo. And then also, since we are using a band-aid, it won't come off when you go swimming or do anything like that, unlike the typical sunscreen sun tattoo. And that's also pretty dangerous to do with sunscreen, so I definitely recommend using a band-aid instead if you want to get a cute sun tattoo. Last but not least, we have this really cute DIY pineapple flower base. So for starters, all you're gonna need is a pineapple, obviously, and then just cut off the top of the pineapple and then use a knife and kind of hollow out the rest of the pineapple. This is kind of hard, but once you kind of get started, it's a lot easier. So the way I did it is I just started by cutting around the pineapple like this, so right inside the skin. And then once I did that, I took a knife and started carving out the inside of the pineapple. And then I also used a spoon and ice cream scoop to get out the rest of the remaining pieces of the pineapple. Altogether, this took me about 15 minutes, so it was a bit time consuming, but it wasn't too hard. Next, just take a small cup of water and place it inside your pineapple. You could try directly filling up the pineapple with water, but if you were kind of bad at cutting it like me, you may have poked a few holes in your pineapple, therefore the water might just kind of leak out, so I chose to use a small cup and it worked perfectly fine. And last but not least, take your flowers and begin arranging them inside the pineapple, and that is how you make this super cute pineapple vase. So obviously, like the flowers, this vase will go bad after a couple of days, but it's a great decoration to have in your house for a few days during the summer, especially if you're having like a summer party or a barbecue or anything like that. Plus, the combination of the smell of the pineapple and your flowers will make your house smell absolutely amazing. Hope you all enjoyed that video. If you are not already, make sure to subscribe to our channel down below. I post my videos every single Saturday. Also, be sure to follow my Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, and my YouNow for updates on my life outside of YouTube. And I will see you guys next Saturday with a new video. Bye!